How many cores do you need for Star Citizen? I've got 3700X and I'll be turning off some of the cores, turning off some of the threads, SMT, hyperthreading, and doing a bit of overclocking at the end just to see what difference that makes. And then we'll answer the question, how many cores do you need for the game? So here's the setup. 3700X, 32 gigs of RAM, 3080 Founders Edition graphics card, and then it's all done at 1440p because Star Citizen just won't utilize the 3080 at 1440p. So I thought, why not? It'll look nicer for me as I'm doing the testing. So as always, I'm using my Lawville benchmark run, as much as you can benchmark Star Citizen in the state that it's in. But it goes all the way from the house to the New Deal space shop, where you can buy and rent chips. So what we've got first up is, here we go, is the 8-core, 16-thread. Then I went into the BIOS, dropped it down to 6-core, 12-thread. And then again, did some runs at 4-core, 8-thread. And 10 runs at each, although actually I did more at 8-core, 16-thread, and I'll explain why. But just to focus on these three for now, the first two, 8-core, 16, 6-12, felt very playable. They felt good as Star Citizen in a city gets, really. The average, obviously, is high 30s, but that means there's periods where it's in the 40s, which feels pretty smooth. The 4-core, 8-thread, less playable. It wasn't terrible. It wasn't the worst result we'll see today, but it wasn't... It was a notable step down, and that potentially is interesting for anybody who's on maybe an older i7 or definitely the i5s we'll look at in a minute when it's just a 4-core. But there was a notable drop down, and the game performance, when you're averaging 35, there's multiple drops into the 20s. And I think for me, you can feel that quite significantly, feel kind of the slowdown. So that's those ones. Now let's add in the SMT off results, so turning off the threading of the CPUs. And you'll notice straight away, first up result at the top, the 8-core, 8-thread, slightly performs better than the 8-core, 16-thread. Now, if you have done much kind of fiddling around with your processors before, you may be aware of this, that sometimes SMT off or hyperthreading off, if it's Intel, potentially benefits and you get better performance when you actually turn it off. I wasn't convinced by this, so I doubled the testing. So those two top results, 8-core, 8-thread and the 8-core 16-thread, they are only 20 runs of each there just to try and validate this, to check, and it's consistent. The results were higher with the 8-core version with the SMT off. So I would love anybody who is interested enough in these sorts of things or just wants to see what the best performance they can get, I'd love anybody else to try this, maybe with a 3700X or even with the 3900X, 3800X, or even the new 5000 series, to try turning SMT off and see what it does, see if you can work out if it's any better. I wasn't expecting this. I know there are games where you do see better performance with SMT off, but I was surprised. So we'll see if that any of you guys can validate that and see if that's true for you. The other interesting things to look at here would be the bottom there, you've got the two SMT off, the other results. And from that, you can say a 4-core, one of the old i5s, which I did run for a while, you are not going to get particularly nice performance, I don't think. And now you obviously can't compare Intel and AMD exactly, but there's a case to upgrade if you're in that boat. Interestingly, the 6-core version, it's just with SMT off, doesn't see really the same sort of improved performance versus the 6-core 12-thread. And I think from that, you can kind of conclude that the game is utilizing more than 6 cores, so it needs those extra threads there. So you can kind of work out here that the sweet spot, at least in terms of a rough sweet spot, is between 8 cores and 6 cores 12 threads. Like, they are, yeah, anywhere between 6 to 12 and 8 with SMT off, they're really nice playable results. Still very playable on the 4-core 8 and the 6-core 6, but you've definitely taken a dip and it isn't as smooth. But then again, nothing we're talking about here is what you class as smooth gameplay. It's smooth for Star Citizen, if that makes any sense. Next, we're just going to move on to just looking at the percentage use of all these threads. So a couple of interesting things. The 4-core SMT version off is pegged high 100% most of the time. The 8-core SMT off, despite being the best performer, it's getting high. Some of the threads there are punching towards 90, the CPU 6 there, 97 at various points. So although it's performing really well, it is being highly utilized. So it's probably close to the line of being bottlenecked, but performing well. So that's quite interesting. And here's another way to visualize some of those stats. Obviously, you've got the four-core SMT off version here, which is the average CPU load is 95%, and the thread, one of the threads at least, is at 99% average all the way through. So it's really being hammered. The game is absolutely brutal on four cores. It just doesn't really work. And then the interesting thing potentially to look at is the 8-core 16 versus the 8-core 8. And you can see that the average thread load, max thread load, on the 8-core 8 version is high. It's higher at 92%, but it, as we've seen, it's not hurting performance at all. And the average CPU load is 73%, which is obviously much higher than the 56% version on the 8-core 16 thread. But as we've seen, the 8-core 16 thread, despite having resources spare, despite having headroom in theory on the CPU, doesn't perform better, and potentially, as we've seen, performs worse. So that's interesting. Bit of quick overclocking here before trying to make a recommendation after this. I use the Ryzen Clock Tuner utility, which I'll link below, to get to a 4275 overclock. Not very much. There's not much headroom on these CPUs. And the stock one just lets the CPU bounce around as it wants. And then an underclock to 4000 across all cores. So you can see, as you'd expect from overclocking, there is a slight performance bump. And that's not particularly interesting, but it is there. You can slightly bump it. But as I said, there's not much headroom. And apparently the third 3000 series is a bit more sensitive to voltage, so you don't want to mess around too much. Here we are in space. And again, nothing particularly interesting. The overclock, all core 4275 overclock, bumps up a little bit. And just so you know, the way I've tested this is, it's on the same server. I've just used the Ryzen Master software from AMD just to literally just change the frequencies on the fly. So same server, literally just changed the frequencies and then recorded it over a 60-second benchmark. So that's how I've done these ones. Into the IAE when it was still with us. And again, nothing particularly interesting, barely a result there, nothing really of interest. And finally, I've come back to Arc Corp and I went all the way down to 3000 megahertz here. The interest, bizarrely here, the stock performance was lower than the 4000 or core clock. There could be lots of different reasons for that. Again, it's all on the same server, so it shouldn't be to do that. It could have just been something kicked off on the server. But you can see a general pattern of how it scales with frequency. Okay, so what to make of all of that? I would say, firstly, that if you're on an old i5 or maybe even an i7, so they're four-core CPUs or four-core 8-thread hyper-threaded i7, it looks as though there is performance benefit and increase to be had by increasing your core count. So that's what it looks like. Now, you can't obviously directly compare AMD and Intel CPUs. They're not. The architectures are different. They don't scale exactly in the same way, but it looks as though the game will at least use 6 cores, 12 threads, or needs investigating, but just eight cores there on the SMT off result that we saw. So yeah, if you're saying I really want top performance today, you may be, a lot of people I think will be CPU limited and CPU bottlenecked by older, especially i5 processors, but looking at the 4-core, 8-thread, potentially also old i7s. That's one thing. Then the question is, what do you upgrade to? And it looks as though today the sweet spot would be the 5600X, which is basically what everybody, all the kind of big tech YouTubers are saying for gaming. It's the same with Star Citizen. The 5600X, the 6-core 12-thread CPU looks good. There's no real loss in performance versus the 8-thread 16-core test that I've done here. But this being Star Citizen, you never know. We don't know what's going to happen. That's where it sits today, but you don't want next patch, maybe into next year, 3.13, whatever we'll be on. You don't want suddenly they change the engine, they do something that suddenly, or the Vulkan implementation suddenly changes things, and you actually are losing performance. We just don't know. As they optimize, the game may get easier to run, or as they keep increasing what the game does and the scale of it and all sorts of things, adding new systems in, it may get more complicated to run. So if it was me, I went and I am in this boat looking to test what I'd love to test next or whenever I can get one, is the Ryzen 5000 series. The question is, do I go for the Ryzen 5600X? Do I go for the 5800X or 5900X? And I have to say, I don't think the 5600X, I won't be, I just won't be. I mean, I do a bit of obviously video editing with this as well, but for Star Citizen specifically, which is the game that I'm obviously most interested in, I think it is risky to just have the 6-core 1230. Even though the results don't look any different today, you don't know where we're going to go in the next couple of years with the game. It's they've said all along they want it to be a PC breaker. They want to push the boundaries, and I think if you were mainly playing Star Citizen, or you at least you want to run Star Citizen really well, you would want that headroom maybe in cores and threads by going for the at least the 5800X. So that would be, I wouldn't blame anybody for just going for the 5600X, but I think if you were being cautious, you may jump up to the 5800X. So you can actually help me because I need to decide what I'm looking for. And I think realistically, do I think money wise, 5800X, obviously £100 cheaper, 5900X, just let me know in the comments below. Maybe I'll put two different comments, one for the 5800X, one 5900X. And if you like the one that you prefer me to try and get, that would be helpful because if people are really interested in seeing the 5900X, despite probably looking at this, that it might not make much difference because the game it's not utilizing fully the 3700X with the 8-core 16-thread. But if people are still interested in seeing the 5900X for the content or just because it's interesting to see, I probably can scrape the money together for that. So let me know below. But that's a load of talking. Hopefully that's useful. Subscribe if that sort of stuff is interesting to you. And there's a few other videos that might be interesting as well. And yeah, the plan with this channel is to do as much technical testing around Star Citizen as possible. So that's it. Subscribe to this. And also come and follow me on Twitch. And when I get to 100,000 Twitch followers, I will get a tattoo of Chris Roberts' face on my foot, which is all definitely going to happen. It's a long way off, but you know, Star Citizen is not going to be finished maybe ever. So we've got loads of time. So yeah, that's this one. See you soon. Bye.